Hey, this is Taylor with three techniques for how to convert PowerPoint to PDF natively from within Microsoft PowerPoint. So no third-party software, websites, or add-ins required. And most importantly, and this is a big one as no one else is covering this, I'm going to show you what kind of content you'll lose in the PPT to PDF conversion process, all right? Not everything in your PowerPoint presentation will properly convert to a PDF. That's why it's important to be aware of what you'll need to spot check in your presentation before you do the conversion process to make sure you don't lose any important information. Now, the two main benefits for converting PPT to PDF are, number one, it decreases the size of your presentation so that you can more easily email or share your slides with other people. For example, I took an 11.4 megabyte PowerPoint file, which was too big to email, and it converted down to just 3.4 megabytes as a PDF file. That's one third the size of the original presentation, which obviously makes it a lot easier to share with other people. And the second benefit is it protects your slides so that others can't make changes to your presentation or easily rip off your content. So with that, let's dive in with the first technique, converting PowerPoint to PDF as full page slides. And the way to do that is through the Save As dialog box, which there's four different ways you can navigate to that feature. The first off, if you come to the File menu and you click Save As, we'll take you to the Save As dialog box. This is the drop down that we want to get access to. You can also File, Export. There is a Create PDF option, which again opens up the dialog box, again taking us to the Save type, or you can hit F12 or Control-Shift-S for your keyboard shortcuts. I'll hit Control-Shift-S, which is again gonna open up this Save As dialog box, and what you're looking for here is Save As type. So you actually have a number of different options for how you can save or share your PowerPoint presentation. You simply wanna select PDF. Now you do have this options button here, which looks like it gives you some include comments or change to the different handout section, but I'm actually gonna show you a better way to do this and get more options for doing it. So for here, I would just select PDF. I will select a location on my computer. I'll click save. You'll see the publishing conversion process. And there you can see my PowerPoint file now has full page slides in the PDF file format. But this is where you need to be aware of what kind of content you'll lose in the PPT to PDF conversion process, which I'll walk you through right now with examples. And the first thing you'll lose is any off-slide content. So if you have any off-slide content like formatting guides, or if you have important notes here on the outside of your slide, or even if you have motion paths or objects, all right, if I just click this motion path, you'll see that the picture is supposed to slide on screen. These all count for off-slide content that you'll want to bring back onto your slide if you need it for your presentation. This would also include, if I open up my notes pane, all right, any notes or speaker notes I have in my presentation, I'll Control-Shift-H to close out of that, or any kinds of comments. These all count as off-slide content that will not properly convert. So if I Control-Shift-S to open the Save As dialog box, Save As type, PDF, select my desktop and convert, I'll click Save. Notice that all of that off-slide content is removed from my presentation, including those speaker notes and comments, which I'll show you how to add a little bit later in this video. The second thing you'll lose in the PDF conversion process are any PowerPoint transitions, animations, or any stacked content that you have in your presentation. For transitions, that includes anything that you add, any of these kind of push, wipes, splits, or any kind of other graphic that you add to move between your slides, those will be removed when you move to the PDF. For animations, this includes anything up here in the entrance, emphasis, or exit effects. All right, all of these, if I hit Shift F5, all of these kinds of appear or disappear animations will be removed and your shapes will just remain exactly where they are. And that's why, if I come to the next one, this motion path effect, all right, of bringing the picture on the slide will be removed as well. The actual motion path animation itself will be removed and the picture will just remain as off-slide content, which you already know will not convert to a PDF. And this also includes, all right, if you have text that you want to bring on slide by slide or click by click. So if I fade these on, notice that these little click animations pop up. Here's the effect options. All of these animations, 1 through 8, will be removed and all of your text will just remain on screen without the animation. Now, one other thing to be aware of here is what I call stacked content. So in this case, if I Shift F5, notice that I bring the S and the W on screen and then I take the O and the W off. So this is kind of creating an interactive presentation. SW comes on, OT comes off, but when you convert to the PDF, these animations will be removed and these shapes will just block it. So if I Control Shift S for Save As, I go to PDF, I select my desktop, I'll just click Save, the conversion process goes. Notice, as I scroll through this, none of the animations, there's the lost picture, There's the text, and this is what I call stacked content. So all of the information, if I flip back to PowerPoint, is lost in this conversion process. So this is something you'll definitely want to double check in your presentation to make sure you don't lose any important information before you convert to a PDF. Now, one thing you won't lose when you convert PPT to PDF are your PowerPoint hyperlinks and Zoom slides if you're using Office 365. So if I come in, select this cloud and Control K to insert a hyperlink, I'm going to jump to a place in this document and I'll jump to Great PowerPoint Shortcuts. So that hyperlink will carry over. This screen tip is not going to carry over, and I'll show you that in just a second. So that's one kind of hyperlink that will work. If you have the latest version of Office 365, you can click and drag slides onto another slide, which is a cool way to quickly create dashboards. These are hyperlinks themselves. And if you've never seen this before, Zoom Tools Format, Return to Zoom. What this allows me to do is Shift F5. I can click on the slide, which will jump to that slide, and I can zoom back. Or I can jump to the PowerPoint shortcuts and come back. So these will carry over. I'll Control Shift S just to demo this. Select my desktop, change my file type to PDF, click Save. It's going to convert. All of a sudden, you'll see I have the PDF file. Remember, I hyperlinked the cloud. I can now click the cloud to jump to the PowerPoint shortcuts. It won't jump back. I'll then come back up to my Zoom slides. And again, this will jump to those specific slides here in my presentation. But keep in mind, if I scroll back to the top, remember this cloud, I added a screen tip. So the screen tip does not come over into the PDF file format with that hyperlink. Technique number two, convert PowerPoint to PDF as handouts, which is what you'll want to do if you want to keep your speaker notes, your comments, or have multiple slides per PDF page. Now, right off the bat, it's important to note that you will lose all interactive features when you create handouts like this, including the hyperlinks and Zoom slides that I just showed you. So in this presentation, I have both a lot of notes and a lot of comments on each one of these slides. If I just click through them, you can see all of these speaker notes and comments. So if I don't want to lose these as I move to the PDF file format, I either hit Control P on my keyboard or come to File and Print. And here's where you're going to want to change from full page slides either to notes pages. And notice here, if I open the dropdown again, I have the option to include or not include my comments. Now, right off the bat, notice that I've added my company logo and some company formatting to this notes master. To learn how to do that, you can check out Camille's series on how to create a PowerPoint template. Here you can just click through it. You also have the options to do multiple slides per page if you want to do that as well. In this case, I'm going to do my notes pages. And you're just going to want to make sure that for your printer, you have selected this Microsoft Print to PDF. Click Prints. You're again going to need to select a location on your desktop. I will just scroll down, print over these handouts, click Save. You can see it's printing down below all 14 slides. If I now move to my desktop and open up those handouts, you're going to see all of my slides with both the comments, speaker notes, and if I scroll down, the comments following the speaker notes. Now, the last technique to convert PowerPoint to PDF is through Microsoft Word, which gives you some additional handout options you can't get any other way and allows you to natively edit your handouts first in Microsoft Word before you then convert Word to PDF. To push the conversion process through Word, come up to File, come to Export, select Create Handouts, and Create Handouts again to get this Send to Word dialog box. Now, one of the options you have here that you can't get any other way is blank lines next to slide. Don't ever click this paste link either. That never works. So blank lines next to slide. I'll click OK. The conversion process will start. Sometimes it takes a minute or two. When it's done, you'll simply click Word, and you'll see all of your slides, in this case, with blank lines next to it. Now, this is a native Word document that you can start to edit and format any way you like, which I won't go into here. You can check out my other video on printing PowerPoint notes if you like. But when you're done, you can simply do the same thing. I'll hit F12 for Save As. I'll select my desktop. I will change this to a PDF file format. This will take Word to PDF. I'll click Save. And there you can see my Word document now converted to the PDF file format. So those are three different techniques to convert PowerPoint to PDF. If you like this video, make sure you subscribe to my YouTube channel right now. Just click on the subscribe button below. Also, if you want to learn insider PowerPoint tips and tricks that I only share with subscribers, head over to nutsandboltsspeedtraining.com and sign up for the newsletter. It's free. But now I want to know what you think. Which of these three PowerPoint to PDF techniques do you think you're going to use the most? Let me know by leaving a comment below right now. This is Taylor from Nuts and Bolts Speed Training, and I'll see you at Happy Hour.